Hi guys, Wolf here with something you might know about Elder Scrolls Online, the new game that came out, I think yesterday or something. Well, I've been playing since Early Access and I am an Imperial Dragon Knight thing, and that's my little pet. I call him Tim, and Tim is my favourite. Alright, so basically we're just going to be doing some quests here. Well, that's all we're gonna do. And I'm just gonna kill this. Alright, in this, you get three choices of what you become stuff. I'll do that in another video, what you can become. But I just want to show you some real gameplay and how massive the maps are. Look, if I go onto my maps, this is one small area. And this is like the entire map. Some of this hasn't been done out, but this is the PvP. Since I've known, I've done a little bit of PvP of World versus World. This is the World versus World map. What is crazy massive. And over here is Glenu and stuff. This is the Dragonfall, and this is Old Mary Dominion, and I'm the Ebon. I always can't remember this. I think it's the Ebonheart Covenant. I'm level 13. Right. This is basically just I'm showing you what and if I keep on zoom out this is basically Oblivion. So it shows you all the worlds and stuff. And this is Cold Harbor from Morlagh Bowl. Just to tell you, I got the Imperial Edition because you guys might notice I've got the Imperial stuff. Those swords, shield and stuff. Anyway. So basically, it's just to do some quests, and you got there's a and I'll explain stuff on the way. But I really just want to show you the coolness of this. So let's just walk up here.
Nords, how can they drink so much without falling over?
Because they're pretty good at drinking, maybe? Anyway, I'm just gonna get this waypoint. Because waypoints, you have to go to waypoints, you have and stuff to use them. I mean, they cost gold to go from like anywhere in the map. But if you go to the shrines, right, I've missed it. I've got to. Right, from the shrines, I've got. They don't cost anything. And they're very useful to get around maps because these maps. All right, if I could zoom out, you barely walk anything on this map. There you go. This is like only the starting map. So yeah, I just got it, and like, so you get experience. You basically experience for like almost everything. Sorry if it's laggy because it causes me. It's quite hard, and this might be kind of short because the how long it takes me to upload the videos. Just takes me forever. I'm sorry if it's laggy. So, anyway, I might do some more. Alright, and if you see on my mini map up here, it's like next to where unfortunately, it will probably say where the Bandicam is. Well, basically, if you find one of these arrows and has blue, it probably means you haven't got this quest.
The Vanguard did. They compass I Vivek.
Alright, and I just got a new quest. And you want to keep a look at this, you can like change on the map which ones you want. So these are area maps, and so you can find your quest like things in this area. If you just keep on zooming out, you can find other bits. Alright, these are where the skull. Wait, I'll explain this all. So these are the anchors. If you've seen in the trailer. Those massive skyhook things that come down. Yeah, it's one of the. That's where you can find one of them. You need a group to do that. That is a boss. I know because me and a friend did it, and it was quite hard. But wasn't that quite hard? Anyway. And basically, you're gonna find a boss there or a group of people that are quite hard to kill. You get very good loot. But I didn't think I don't know. This is like something for the main quest, the Harborage and stuff. I won't spoil anything if you haven't played the game. Yeah. That's the it. These are just points on the map you can find. I'll do like a whole thing on world versus world to understand, to make you understand and stuff. But later. Yeah, this is, you could do things. So when it says up there, it will tell you like the main quest for this area. So that's, those are little villages, those are castles, and those are ports. All part of the same village. Those little things that are flashing, they have a blue aura around them, are way shrines. And the things that are covered in black, so like this for example, are places I haven't discovered yet. And those lead to other areas across the map. And those, I think they're like points of interest or something, I'm not sure. But these little black dots, as you can see, are basically just like points of like quests and stuff. So enough of me talking, what I've probably done for most of the recording. I'll try and do a little bit because I haven't got the full version of Bandicam. But I'll try and do it anyway. Because no one really cares. So what's this guy want me to do? Use the prod on Gua 04. I've no idea what Gua is. Are those little weird things that just hop around? Right, no, so basically this is like the beginning video, but I'll have more to come. So I'll see you later. Bye.